The seventh category of emotions that I would like to discuss today is self-criticism and guilt. Imagine a child who is being criticized by his parents. When a child feels guilty and is about to cry, they pucker their face. This is similar to our facial expression when we eat salty or sour food. When we want to suppress feelings of guilt, we are more likely drawn to salty and sour food. It can be anything from salty pickles to grapefruits. Another example is people who are drawn to citrusy flavor in their food. Often we are not dealing with the guilt that stems from something that has happened yesterday, but rather a feeling of guilt that has been building up inside the person for years. This can be a feeling of guilt that they have not been the best son or daughter, the best husband or wife, or the best parents. Mothers often feel guilt when they compare themselves with other mothers. This inclination to compare ourselves with others and the desire to be the best can bring about a lot of self-criticism and guilt. When we are feeling self-critical, we often eat salty food. It can be as simple as salty nuts or crackers with sea salt. Some people like to add soy sauce to most of their dishes. A desire for salty food might be a sign of self-criticism and internal disapproval of our own actions. People who like to eat salty food often feel that they are not good enough. They tend to be perfectionists. People who have high expectations for themselves and don't allow themselves to make mistakes are subconsciously drawn to salty and sour food. You might know a person who likes to add extra salt to their food. Sour food is more related to feelings of guilt, which often comes in a pair with self-criticism. When we criticize ourselves, we think that we are not good enough and we feel guilty. Guilt is also a form of hidden anger. This is a specific type of anger that is directed inwards. A person is angry at himself. He is slowly destroying himself. Let's talk about the difference between outer anger and inner anger. When a person is angry at somebody else, he can express his anger by arguing, by fighting, or even being rude to that person. The destructive power of this type of anger is pointed outward. The feeling of guilt always comes with an internal anger. The person has turned on himself. The destructive force of this type of anger is pointed inward. Sports like running or boxing can be a great way to release the outer anger, but it does not always help with inner anger. When you are angry at somebody else, it's much simpler than being angry toward yourself. If another person did something bad to you, then you have the full right to be angry at him. You can reject him, you can avoid him, you can stop answering his phone calls, you can choose to no longer be his friend. You can distance yourself from that person and even completely eliminate him from your life. But when you are angry with yourself, you have no way to create distance. You are stuck with yourself. It is extremely hard to ignore and avoid your own feelings. These feelings are growing inside of you and they're destroying you. One of the easiest ways to deal with these feelings is to suppress them with food. An example, let's say a man who works as a manager in a company has prepared a detailed presentation to attract future clients. He goes and presents his ideas, but because of the time limit, he can't go over the whole presentation and must skip a few pages. Although the presentation was good, he feels that he did not do his best work. He did less than he expected from himself. He criticizes himself for not being able to manage his time better. At the same time, he feels guilty because his company gave him such an important task and in his mind, he did not deliver 100%. If this man does not work on his internal critic, then these negative emotions will continue to grow inside of him. He will always find flaws in his work and feel guilty, anger, and low self-esteem. Within time, he starts going to a local bar after work. He ordered a beer, he squeezes a lime into his beer, and he likes his beer with salty nuts and crackers that come complimentary. Let's decode this type of behavior. Salt. Salt is a suppressant for self-criticism. Nuts or crackers are suppressants for anger. A squeezed lime adds a sour flavor to the beer and suppresses feelings of guilt. When he leaves the bar, he feels good, but only temporarily. He was able to deal with his emotions at that specific moment. If you have any questions about the online course or about the topic of today's webinar, please write them down in the comment section of this video. We all have a wide variety of complex emotions and feelings. If you notice that you eat more than you need, then start paying attention to the type of foods that you crave. In the last example, with the man in the bar, we saw how he was using food to deal with three emotions at once. Usually, people never suppress one specific emotion. Our emotions are complex, and we are often dealing with several emotions at once. Each of us expresses a dozen emotions during the day. That's why it's important to be aware of your own feelings, to be aware of your own behavioral patterns, and it's extremely important to learn how to express our emotions in a healthy way. On the online course Weight Loss Vaccine, I give you specific exercises for how to identify your own emotions and how to release them in a healthy way. There are a total of 12 weeks in this program. One of them is dedicated to anger management and another to self-criticism. I highly recommend you take this course even if you are not overweight but having troubles managing your emotions. Most young people have a good metabolism and they might not notice that they eat too much. Once we get older, we start noticing that our body cannot process the same number of calories anymore. We start gaining weight. We want to eat less, but we can't. In my personal experience, most people don't know how to manage their feelings. They don't know how to manage their emotions. They don't notice how they use food to deal with their emotions. They do it subconsciously. Society discourages us from expressing our negative emotions freely, so we have to suppress them. Over the years, we store more and more emotion inside of ourselves. At some point, we cannot hold them in anymore. People can experience emotional breakdowns, depression, panic attacks, and anxiety. Oftentimes, they start eating more to deal with their feelings. At some point, they cannot control their appetite. Logically, they can understand that they have eaten a lot, but they still feel hungry. The link to the 12-week online course Weight Loss Vaccine is under this video. I want to be clear, this course is not about dieting or exercises. I do not teach about counting calories. This course is about addressing the psychological reasons why people eat more food than they need. This course is about healing your body and mind from emotional eating. There are total 5 free webinars about emotional eating and about how we use food to suppress our feelings and emotions. All the links to all 3 webinars you can find in the video description. Click like if you find this video helpful and consider subscribing to my newsletter so you will be notified about my future webinars and online courses. All links are in the video description. Again, my name is Elena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. Looking forward to seeing your questions, to seeing your comments, and will be happy to see you on my online course Weight Loss Vaccine.